please, no flash photography or video recording unless you want to, then it's okay. And I'm Franky T, and welcome to the Windjammer Motel and Lounge. Your beverages are being prepared by Joe the bartender. And he has come up with a new cocktail that he told me about. I had a few of them last night, and they are very good. He calls them a tequila mockingbird. And he's never served one to an empty seat. I asked Joe if he's had any quirky patrons over the years. He goes, well, there was this pair of jumper cables that came in one day. And they hopped up on a bar stool, and he said, he looked at him and he said he knew there were going to be trouble. So he looked at him, he says, okay, you can stay, but don't start anything. And there was this baby seal that came in one day. He was swimming down the Atlantic, and he stopped, this was this past summer, he stopped on a Seaside Park beach for a rest. He didn't have a badge on. The badge checkers got him, kicked him off the beach. He found his way down here, hopped up on a stool over there, and Joe says, hey, what'll it be? Baby Seal says, I'll have anything except a Canadian club. And there's this local guy, Scotty. Scotty comes in here one day with a steering wheel sticking out of his kilt. So Joe says, hey, Scotty, doesn't that bother you to have a steering wheel sticking out of your kilt? He goes, aye, it's driving me nuts. And I'm Franky T. And who is Franky T? Well, I'm going to tell you who Franky T is. I tell you. My day did not start off great. I accidentally swallowed a bunch of Scrabble tiles this morning. My grandkids probably put them in my special K, which means my next crap could spell disaster. that was a shitty one. I've been everywhere. I've done everything. I can't remember much, but I am trying to get in shape, so I'm going to a gym. Right? My favorite machine in the gym? Bending. I don't think I actually need any more exercise. I'm getting a lot of exercise now carrying the coffins of friends of mine who did exercise. I actually lost 20 pounds this summer. Unfortunately, I was in London at the time. My gym and all gyms have mirrors. They have mirrors all over the place. Why they have mirrors, I don't know. But every time I look in a mirror, I think of the first job I had out of college, cleaning mirrors. I tell you, it was a job I could really see myself doing. Reflect on that one, huh? I've had lots of jobs. I was a bartender at the Betty Ford Clinic. I worked at a paper company, but it folded. I was an electrician, but I found the work shocking, and I was discharged. I worked in pool maintenance, but I found it just so draining. I worked as a historian for a while, but I soon realized there's no future in it. I worked as an accountant, but I kept waking up late at night because I kept hearing these strange invoices. But the best job I ever had was a bank teller. I tell you, that was a great job. I was taking home $350,000 a week. I only collected unemployment once in my life. Yeah, and two of us got laid off. We were working for the Victoria's Secret's panty factory. So we go to the unemployment office, have our interview. I go in first. I tell them I was a panty stitcher, and I got $275 a week unemployment. Not bad. So my buddy Billy Bob goes in after me. He tells them he's a diesel fitter. He gets $375 a week. He comes out and he tells me he's making $100 a week more than me. I go, well, this ain't right. I go back into the unemployment office. I go to the clerk and say, hey, why is he getting $100 a week more than me? It's not right. He goes, I'm sorry, sir, but there's a special government grant that gives engineers more money. and a diesel fitter fits those qualifications. I go, wait a minute. He's no engineer. He was in quality control. Every time I stitched a pair of panties, I give him the Billy Bob. He put them on, and if he can get them up over his fat ass, he goes, yeah, diesel fitter. Oh, and now, what's coming up? Coming up next is our featured singer, who is also all the backup singers, Rupert. Now, Rupert is an interesting guy. He's a character. He's strange. He's humble, and he has a lot to be humble about. Rupert is a real animal lover. At least he was until the court order. Rupert went on a cruise this past January. And on his cruise, he went on one of them excursions to a rainforest, got lost, got captured by cannibals. They put him in a cage, and every day they stabbed him and drank his blood. Well, this went on for a couple of weeks until finally he couldn't stand it anymore. So he demanded to see the chief. He says, you can kill me and eat me if you want, but I'm sick and tired of getting stuck for the drinks. Well, Rupert's fully recovered. He's full of young blood. It's just in a real old container. Rupert, come on out.
You asked me for a contribution. Well, you know, we are doing what we can. But if you want money for people with my sad head, all I can tell you is, brother, you have to wait. I said, you know where it's gonna be. Good evening, and are we too loud for you?
No!
Good evening, and welcome to the Windjammer. This is really a great event for me. I can't believe all of you people came to see this ridiculous act. But I am having fun, and I can guarantee you this, the more you drink, the better I will sound. So I will try my hardest. Look, I got a groupie over here already. Look at this. Huh? I'm sorry, honey, I'm married. We just got back from Vegas. We didn't do a show there, we were on vacation. But... All right, so this next song, take it easy, Johnny. The next song really is about me and Yoko. Do you remember Yoko? And it's about when we got married. It's a whole story about me and Yoko when we got married. Hampton, trying to get to Holland or France. The man in the Mac says, you gotta go back. You know, they didn't even give us a chance. Crack, you know it ain't easy. You know how hard it can be. I flew in from Miami, P-O-A-C. Didn't get to bed last night. On the way, the paperback was on my knee. Man, I had a dreadful flight. I'm back in the USSR. Don't have luck, you are, boy. Back in the USSR. Oh,
It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us, only sky.
Play the game.